Before I start this video, I just wanted to let you know about the Super Aminos that I've been using, and I've been getting some great results from it, but I noticed that some of you guys, or a lot of you guys, haven't even tried them yet, even though if you use the link in the description, you get $50 off. And I just recently got a testimonial from Ben Gorski, and he bought the Super Aminos, and he's noticing some good results, so here he is, just listen to him.
Hey Mountain, so I've had these Super Aminos for about 2 weeks now, and it's pretty incredible what's going on. I take about 2 to 3 every 3 to 4 hours, kind of following what Vince Guaranda did back in the 60s, and I just feel like I'm always recovering. I can push harder at the gym.
There you go, guys. With the $50 discount and everything like that, this is a no-brainer. So I highly recommend that you try them if you haven't tried them so far. And let me know what you think, and send me a message on Instagram or YouTube or whatever, and let me know. Thanks a lot for watching this video, and here we go.
Mountain.
Train the muscles, not the joints.
Welcome back to Natural Glam Bodybuilding, and today I'm going to talk to you about a few ways to refine your groove, hence getting stronger. Because the more coordinated you are, the easier it will be for you to be stronger. So one of the ways that I've found in order to get stronger is to refine a groove by doing a lot of sets with a particular movement. So this means the old powerlifter technique, where they basically keep a few reps in the tank, but they constantly revisit set after set after set. Therefore, they can do more sets with a given heavy weight because they're not relying on muscular fatigue to dictate whether they stop the set or not. It's more about nervous system fatigue. So basically their goal is when they start to get really shaky, that's kind of when their nervous system starts to hit a failure or starts to fatigue. And the whole goal of this is to attack an exercise so much though that the groove becomes second nature. So if you're doing 10 or 15 sets for an exercise, but you're not hitting failure, it's not quite so hard on the immune system and on the recovery system. But at the same time, you get a chance to throw that ball, metaphorically speaking, right? Throw that ball over and over again until coordination becomes perfected. So in this way, this is how higher volume or multiple sets can help you find that perfect groove. Now, I'm not saying to do this all the time, but this could be one technique if you're struggling with an exercise in order to refine your coordination and to increase your exercise efficiency and strength in that given movement. Now, the other way to increase your coordination is to stick to a given movement. So say every time you train chest and you want to get better at the bench press, well, make sure you bench press almost every single time that you train chest. Now, I know this is counterintuitive compared to what I teach when it comes down to my bodybuilding programs or bodybuilding training in general, but say you're struggling with the individual movement, such as the squat or the deadlift or bent over row or whatever it might be, and you want to really get better at that one movement, well, the best thing to do is to attack that movement often and always. So basically, you always start your workout with that movement, and you make sure every time you train that body part, you train that particular exercise. And this will ensure that you'll increase your coordination and therefore your strength in that movement over the long run. So again, I do believe in switching things up and switching up exercises and so forth. But at the same time, for short periods of time, it's good to specialize in a particular exercise, right? So you'll see bench press specialists, or you'll see squat specialists or deadlift specialists. This is why they do this, is because they're trying to perfect their coordination, and therefore their strength will go up in that movement. And sometimes it actually lowers the risk of injury as well, because when you're coordinated, you're not shaking all over the place and you're not losing your balance. And therefore you are able to make sure that you're not having unexpected jolts or stretches in muscles in weird ways and therefore getting an injury. So a refined groove can really help you when it comes down to avoiding injury too, especially when you're working with heavier weights. So yeah, every time you attack a certain muscle group, you start with that exercise and you do make sure no matter what, you get that exercise in. And then no matter what, you make sure that the exercise that you want to refine or get better at, that's what you start the workout with. And you make sure every workout that you train that body part, that's the exercise you use primarily. Even though you might be doing some assistant work in the background, or maybe say you're starting off with barbell bench because you want to get better at barbell benches, and then you may do some dumbbell bench after. But for the most part, you start with that barbell bench, and no matter what chest workout you're doing, you always are doing barbell bench until you feel like you've gotten a certain amount of proficiency in that exercise. And then from there, you can start switching things up again. Now, the final way to get ultimate coordination when it comes down to training is super high frequency. Now, funny enough, I'm mentioning this because on my website right now, I should have the super high frequency training training program available for you. But one thing I found is that training body parts more frequently allows you to establish more coordination and proficiency in training those body parts. Now, if you combine this with a particular exercise, you'll notice that your coordination in that particular exercise will go up exponentially. So if you bench press every day, maybe you're doing lighter weight, but you'll find that your bench press groove becomes extremely fine-tuned, right? So the whole basis of this, if you wanted to just focus on coordination itself, is to not burn the muscle out, but to constantly remind the body how to find that groove. You might be using like 60% of the weight that you usually use, but then you're training that body part every day, and because of that, your groove becomes more refined. Now, of course, you can start working into hypertrophy and start doing some more reps and start to work the muscle and stuff, but in the end, just training a body part or a particular exercise more often will add to proficiency, which is why all athletes that are heavily dictated by coordination do their sport almost every single day, even if it's a light type of day, right? So you'll see with hockey players, they'll go for a light skate or a light stick handle. You'll see baseball players just go for a light throw, you know, just pass the ball around. Because what they're trying to do is refine that coordination, but not burn their system out or not burn their tissue out, right? So in this way, coordination can be increased. Now, what does this mean to you as a bodybuilder? Well, when your coordination is increased, you'll be able to handle more weight for more repetitions and therefore experience higher amounts of hypertrophy. So it's a nice blend between the two. You don't want to go so frequently that you're basically burning yourself out. But if you are going to go super high frequency, then what you would do is lower amounts of volume, or you wouldn't hit failure as often. And then you'll notice that you're going to get a lot more benefit as far as coordination goes without getting tissue burnout. So those are three tips that I have for you when it comes down to increasing your coordination and helping you get better at a particular exercise, therefore gaining in muscle mass. I hope this helps you out in your training. Thanks a lot for watching. And if you need to get a hold of me, just go to naturalglambodybuilding.com. And thanks to the patient supporters, and take care for now. Yeah.